Tēnā koe, Shane. Thank you so much for being up bright and early. Looks like a gorgeous morning there. Congratulations on the result. First of all, your response, your reaction to the results from last night.
Yeah, kia ora, folks. Look, it's reflective of the 2 years of hard work. Obviously, our leader, Winston, covered the four winds of the country, packed the town halls, and we had a really spirited campaign, and the dividend has arrived.
What do you make of the election results more broadly?
Oh, as you know, I came into politics in 2005 with Helen Clark, and the result in the Māori seats reminds me of the time when Dr. Sharples and Korowetere and others all disappeared in 1996. And also in the days of Helen Clark. So there's substantial changes there in the Māori seats, and it's rather ironic that the strength of the Māori seats actually increases the value of the joker in the pack for New Zealand First.
Yeah, talk to us about the joker in the pack. What do you see the role of New Zealand First being in the next government?
Too early to tell. Obviously, as Winston said last night, let's wait. The cards are still being shuffled, and it's between 15 and 20% of these votes that still need to be counted. But I'd remind everyone, 2008, 11, 14, 17, the Tory vote went down, and in some cases they lost up to two seats. So there's a wee bit of uncertainty to go just yet.
Would you say then that the likeliest scenario is that New Zealand First will be required in order to command a majority of the House?
Well, as I said, mate, I spent the night, I exchanged last night a gallon of plonk for a victory cigar. So let's just tie-ho there, mate, and wait until all the votes are counted. But Winston has said both last night and earlier during the campaign, we're here to put the interests of garden variety Kiwis to the fore.
When is Winston Peters expecting to have conversations with Christopher Luxon?
Well, I'm not entirely sure whether or not Christopher Luxon has sent any messages our way. A number of the members of his caucus are well known to us. Obviously, Mark Mitchell and myself, we all played in the Golden Oldie rugby team. But look, those discussions at this stage are above my pay grade, and I'll leave it to, as we say in the North, the rangatira, Winston.
So if New Zealand First is a part of the next government, or New Zealand First support makes up the formation of the next government or a component of the support for the next government, what will be the priorities for your party?
Oh, look, I want to remind people that during the lead-up to this campaign, we were marginalised. Our contribution was undervalued. The voters have spoken. Obviously, there are ongoing issues still to be addressed, pertaining to the way in which the whole COVID experience was managed. Both Winston and I, with our roots to the north, want to ensure that the treaty is not continually unhinged from its historic moorings. But nothing trumps the uncertainty, anxiety that garden variety Kiwis feel about paying their bills and being secure in their own houses, in their own company, and in their own community. I mean, we campaigned on these things.
One of the dynamics that is most interesting to me from the results last night is that at the same time we've seen ACT record its strongest ever result, we've seen New Zealand First return to Parliament and National recording a relatively strong result. ACT and New Zealand First, of course, having campaigned with pretty strong messages around the role of the treaty in New Zealand society and New Zealand law, New Zealand governance. Compare that with the rise of Te Pāti Māori, a party that says explicitly it is a tiriti-centric party. How do you see those kind of dynamics and divided politics playing out during the next parliamentary term?
In 1975, Winston was the lawyer for the Ngāti Wai Land Retention Committee. In the 90s, I rose to be the Treaty of Waitangi Fisheries Commission chairman. There is nothing about the treaty that can be taught to Winston and I. And one thing that we are not in agreement is the movement away from a bicultural, bilingual comprehension of the treaty. This notion that you can only understand the treaty through the Māori language version, and I grew up speaking the Māori language, It is both wrong, and it needs to be restored to where Eddie Jury, Machu Rata, and that generation, when they kicked off the whole treaty experience, it needs to be put back into a more balanced position.
What's on the cards today?
Yesterday was fisheries. Hopefully, I'm going to catch the end of the All Blacks game. You can hear a little bit of shouting in the background. But look, it was black and white victory in terms of restoring us to Parliament last night. And all going well, it'll be an All Blacks victory later during the course of this morning.
Very good. On that note, thank you so much for your time and for getting up early for us this morning. We really appreciate it. That is New Zealand First returning MP Shane Jones, live for us in Kororareka, Russell.